Hello and welcome to our monthly financial analysis on a residential multi-unit building here in Ottawa. And this is a property that sold in December of 2019, and we'll break out the numbers on it for you. Now, this was a building located in Hintonburg, sort of central west Ottawa, and the sold price was $750,000, and it had three legal one-bedroom units in it, and the property was fire retrofit. So let's go through the numbers. The rental income on it, the scheduled rental income, was almost $40,000. I'll round off these numbers so they may be a little bit different than what you're looking at on the screen. So again, $40,000. The effective rental income would therefore be a little over $38,000, and that gives us and the total operating expenses was $16,000, and that also includes 5% for maintenance and 5% for management, by the way. So that leaves us a net operating income of a little over $22,000. So that NOI looks a little bit on the shy side to me. Let's see what happens here. Cap rate is 3%. That's really low. So it's telling us more of the story of what we can expect as a bottom line here. The operating expense ratios, they're actually quite high at 42%. I would prefer to see this around 35. Now, multiple times the gross, sold for 19 times the gross. You know, typically we'll see 12, 13, 14 times the gross. So again, this is kind of supporting the low cap rate. The multiple times the net, that's 33, and that just means if you take the selling price and divide the net income into it, it's 33 times. And that number is usually around 22, 23, 24 for a nice building. This was 33 times the net. So going by a typical down payment where we should see a small positive cash flow, this and that amount, by the way, is 35% down. That would be about $262,000, leaving us with a mortgage of about $487,000. Now, that mortgage at 2.8% rate and you amortize it over 25 years, that means that the ADS, the annual debt service on that mortgage, is $27,000 a year. So we know that our net income is about 22. We know that our annual debt service is $27,000. So this property had a negative cash flow of $4,647. So this tells me that either the buyer had pretty deep pockets and the bank financed it anyhow, but more than likely the purchaser probably went in with a much higher down payment. So negative cash flow, and consequently we've got a negative ROI of 1.8%. So what that means is that he invested his down payment, $262,000, and in return for that, if there was the 35% down payment, he ends up with a negative cash flow. So that's the story on this building. If you'd like to subscribe to our channel, on the top left of your screen, the icon, click on there and you'll get sent all this great information every month. Thank you.